Greetings. This is the fifth video in a series to teach about the Trinity. I want to focus this on a passage I have grown to love because of how it describes and includes the members of the Trinity. John 14:6. Jesus saith unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. As a Christian, when you see this verse, the word Father jumps out at you. Jesus calls God his Father. This confirms the Trinity, that Jesus is the Son of God and God is his Father. Those are two aspects of the Trinity. But that is not all this one verse holds. Jesus also calls himself Allah when he says, I am the truth. So even in this one verse, we see several indications of the Trinity. We see that God is Jesus' Father, and we see that Jesus is God. Perhaps a Mohammedan would ask, how does Jesus call himself Allah? The truth, in Arabic, Al-Haq, is one of the 99 names of Allah. And Jesus says, I am Al-Haq. I am the truth. So when Jesus says, I am the truth, he is saying, I am Al-Haq, which is the same as saying, I am Allah. John 14:7. If you had known me, you should have known my Father also, and from henceforth you know him and have seen him. Notice Jesus says, from henceforth, meaning from now on, you know God. You have seen God. According to Jesus, if you know Jesus, you know God. How can Jesus make such a statement? He can only say that by knowing him, you know God, if Jesus is God. This is only the second verse into this passage, and I think it's marvelous. But it only makes sense if Jesus is God. John 14:8. Philip saith unto him, Lord, show us the Father, and it sufficeth us. Bless his heart. Philip has just missed what Jesus has said. But I'm not sure any of us would have done any better. Check out what Jesus says next. And Jesus saith unto him, Have I been so long time with you, and yet have you not known me, Philip? Think about that, my friend. Jesus has just said, He that knows me knows God. Philip says, Jesus, okay, show us, show God to us, and that is enough. Jesus, almost aghast, asks, How long have you been with me and still do not know me? Don't! Head slap. He that hath seen me hath seen the Father. And how do you say then, Show us the Father? He that hath seen me has seen the Father. Let that sink in. He that hath seen me has seen the Father. How then can you ask, Philip, show us the Father? This is another very interesting study in the invisible writing in the Bible. These words are literally invisible to those who call themselves Muslim. It is invisible that Jesus calls God his Father. For some reason, Mohammedans are completely blind to Jesus calling God his Father, over and over. Muslims are blind to words that contain the truth, and only the grace of God can remove that spirit of blindness from their eyes. Believest thou not that I am in the Father and the Father in me? Gee, he just called God the Father twice. In one sentence, the words that I speak unto you, I speak not of myself, but the Father that dwells in me. Yeah, called God a Father three times in one verse. He doeth the works. Jesus says he is in the Father, and the Father is in him. This speaks of the inseparable unity of the Trinity. When Jesus says the Father and I are one, it's because Jesus is in God and God is in Jesus. They are one. They are inseparable. No human being can separate Jesus from God. The words that I speak unto you, I speak not of myself, but the Father that dwelleth in me, he doeth the works. The Father that dwells in me. Jesus continues to speak of his closeness to God in terms unheard of in the history of humanity. Believe me that I am in the Father, and the Father in me, or else believe me for the very works' sake. Jesus repeats this relationship, that he is in the Father, and the Father is in him. Then essentially says, if you don't believe what I'm saying, then believe me because of the miracles I work. And Jesus never once said, by Allah's permission. O Mohammedan, I know the Quran says 43 times, by Allah's permission. This is Muhammad excusing his impotence. Why, O Mohammedans, do you believe a do-nothing man? Jesus said, if you do not believe my words, that I am in God and God is in me, then believe the works I perform. The works prove the words. This is in stark contrast to the cheap imitation of a man who could not work any sign or miracle and did nothing. Why believe a do-nothing man when the Son of God has flat out told you he is God, and believe him because of the works he can and does do? Oh, Muslims, there will be no excuse when you stand before the Son of God on the last day. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do shall he do also, and greater works than these shall he do, because I go unto my Father. And whatsoever you shall ask in my name, that will I do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. This is speaking of the future. We, Christians, ask in Jesus' name. That's why we pray in Jesus' name. Notice Jesus says, that will I do. When you pray, ask in my name, and that will I do. Jesus answers prayers. And he did not say, by Allah's permission. Why? That the Father may be glorified in the Son. Look at what Jesus says. When Jesus is glorified, God is glorified. As we study the Trinity, we continue to see the unity of Jesus and God. John 14:14, if you shall ask anything in my name, I will do it. Jesus says, I will do it, and not by Allah's permission. John 14:15, if you love me, keep my commandments. Jesus doesn't say keep God's commandments, but he is saying keep God's commandments, because Jesus is God. And I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another Comforter, that he may abide with you forever. Notice how Jesus spoke with authority. I will pray, and God shall give. He shall give you another Comforter. God will do what Jesus asks. There's no namby-pamby hedging here. There's no if it's Allah's will. There's no inshallah. There's no by Allah's permission. This is I will pray the Father and He shall give you another comforter. That's a statement of fact. That He, the Comforter, may abide with you, may live with you forever. The Comforter will live with you forever. Will live with believers forever. That means the Comforter is eternal. The Comforter lives forever. Here in this one verse, we see all three members of the Trinity. Jesus praying, we see the Father doing, and the Comforter, the Holy Spirit, abiding forever. If you respect what Jesus says, your heart should hear His words and hear His message. Open your heart to hear what Jesus is saying. Even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive because it seeth Him not, neither knoweth Him, but you know Him, for He dwelleth with you, and shall be in you. Jesus calls the Comforter the Spirit of truth, because the Holy Spirit is a spirit. The world cannot see the Holy Spirit. This confirms the Trinity with God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. John 14:18. I will not leave you comfortless. I will come to you. And this is one of those very interesting declarations by Jesus. I will come to you. Wait a minute. Jesus said God would send the Comforter to you. Then Jesus said He will not leave us comfortless or comforterless. He will come to us. Jesus will send the Comforter, and Jesus will come to us. So here's John 14:16, and I will pray the Father, and He shall give you another Comforter. And John 14:18, I will not leave you comfortless. I will come to you. What is Jesus doing talking about people being comfortless? He just said God would send the Comforter. And then Jesus says He will come to us. John 14:19. Yet a little while, and the world seeth me no more. But you see me, because I live, you shall live also. At that day you shall know that I am in my Father, and you in me, and I in you. He that hath my commandments and keepeth them, he it is that loveth me. And he that loveth me shall be loved of my Father, and I will love him, and will manifest myself to him. Jesus saying He will manifest myself has meaning. Judas saith unto Him, not Iscariot, Lord, how is it that Thou wilt manifest Thyself unto us, and not unto the world? Jesus answered and said unto him, if a man love me, he will keep my words, and my Father will love him, and we will come unto him and make our abode with him. And we, this is Jesus and God, and we will come unto him and make our abode with him. We will make our house with him. So in John 14:16, and I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another Comforter. John 14:18, I will not leave you comfortless. I will come to you. John 14:23, and we will come unto him and make our abode with him. First, Jesus said the Comforter would come to you. The Comforter is the Holy Spirit, the third member of the Trinity. Then Jesus said He would come to you. Well, if the Holy Spirit is God, and Jesus is one with God, when the Holy Spirit comes to you, Jesus is also coming to you. Now Jesus expands and says, He and God the Father will abide with you. If you are Christian, you should be getting excited. The Holy Spirit is God. The Holy Spirit in you is God in you. Now, if you call yourself Muslim, you may want to ask and pray whether your heart desires a relationship with God where God comes and lives in you. Looking at this passage, Christians can see the manifestation of the Trinity. If you call yourself Muslim, words like this passage in John 14, spoken by Jesus Himself, teach us about the Trinity, revealed by the Holy Spirit of God. The Word of God teaches us, the words of Jesus teach us from the true Injil, that where the Holy Spirit is, there too is Jesus, and there too is God the Father. There are many such teachings by Jesus in the true Injil that reveal His unity with God the Father and God the Holy Spirit. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.